Howdy, welcome to Dodge Brothers. What in the world am I doing right now? Doesn't it seem like a waste of time, wear and tear on equipment, diesel fuel, and labor to be out here tearing up the ground in the fall when we're just gonna come right back and till the soil in the spring ahead of the planter? Wouldn't it be a better idea to leave the corn stalks on top of the ground to protect the dirt throughout the winter and protect from erosion in the early spring? And wouldn't it be an even better idea to adopt no-till practices across all of our acres? These are some of the questions that I get most often regarding fall tillage. Now, I can't answer on behalf of every farmer everywhere. All I can do is tell you why we do the things we do and why these practices work best for us in our area. Stay tuned.
Hey there, thanks for turning down my road. My little brother and I both work for local farmers full-time, but we both also farm together with our cattle herd and our hay operation. Everybody's involved, from the smallest to the biggest. If you don't have the joy of farming yourself, I'd love to help you experience it through this channel. Whatever your background, you found the right place. This is Dodge Brothers Farm and Ranch.
Hey, before we jump into the subject matter, I'd like to just take a couple seconds to ask you a quick favor. If you enjoy this video and feel like you've learned something, I'd be so happy if you'd hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it so that you'd never miss out on another video when it comes out. All right, let's tear right into the subject of fall tillage. One of the characteristics of good corn is its ability to stand throughout windstorms of the summer and still be vertical at harvest time. Now, if you have a good, strong, sturdy stalk that's capable of holding the corn up all summer, it's also hard to break down after harvest. So right now, we're trying to bury all of this residue as best we can so that it starts to decompose and those root balls break down so that we can make a nice uniform seed bed to plant into come springtime. You don't want your seeds pinched up against old corn stalks, and you don't want them stuck between root balls. You want the seed to soil contact to be as firm and uniform as possible. So that's what we're doing right now, is trying to get rid of some of this extra trash and get it to decompose so that we can do a great job in the spring. Another potential problem created by all of this corn stalk cover on the ground is that it traps the moisture in the ground. Now, this can be a good thing in the middle of a drought, but it's not a good thing in the springtime in Northeast Iowa when we need to get into the fields as quickly as possible. Every year when it's time to roll in the spring, the chisel plowed ground is always ready before the non-chisel plowed ground. So that's the second thing we're trying to accomplish, is expose some black dirt and loosen the soil up so that come spring, it'll dry out as quickly as possible and we can get rolling to plant some of these longer season hybrids before it's too late. All right, number three, we need to try to relieve some of the compaction that we created during our fall harvest process. This fall was especially tough. It was wet all season long, and we had to harvest in some conditions that we normally would not be willing to harvest in. And thus, we did some damage to the soil. We left behind some tracks with the grain cart and the grain cart tractor, and we even made a mess with the combine in a few areas. Although we're only going 8 inches deep with the chisel plow, we are able to break up some of that surface compaction that we created during harvest and restore the soil's ability to breathe and absorb water. To repair the damage below 8 inches, we're counting on some really good, hard freeze and thaw cycles this winter to break up some of that subsoil compaction. And a fourth reason that we do fall tillage is to mix in our fertilizer. We lay down a lot of hog manure every fall with a dragline hose applicator system. The hog manure is a great benefit to our soil with all of the nitrogen, potassium, phosphorus, and all of the micronutrients found in manure that you don't necessarily get in your simple commercial fertilizer blend. But even though it's injected into the ground with the hose applicator, it's definitely prone to leaching off nitrogen into the air, especially if you apply your manure early in the season when the temperatures are still warm outside. So we're turning this dirt over partially in an effort to mix in that manure and try to hold on to as much of the nutrients as possible. The ground that didn't get manure has been spread with dry commercial fertilizer, and right now it's just laying on top of the soil waiting to get mixed in. Now, if we got a good hard rain, it would put that fertilizer down into the soil where it needs to be, but we're certainly helping it along with this piece of equipment right now. We're burying all of those nutrients under the soil and mixing everything around to make it a little bit more uniform in terms of fertility. So those are the four main reasons why we chisel plow our corn on corn acres every year. Now, there are a few fields that we are not going to perform any fall tillage on. The fields that had soybeans on them this year and will get planted to corn next year will get no fall tillage. We go right in there in the spring with our spring tillage rig and make a nice seed bed right ahead of the planter. The reason we're able to do this is the soybean fields have much less residue, and that residue is chopped up extremely fine and breaks down much more easily than the corn residue does. And the ground is a lot smoother. We're able to go in there in one pass in the spring and make a really nice mellow seed bed. And then the fields that were corn this year and will have soybeans on them next year will also get no fall tillage. In fact, they won't get any spring tillage either. We no-till our soybeans right in between the old corn rows, and it works great for us. The reason we're able to get away with that in Northeast Iowa is that we don't need to have our soybeans planted quite as early as we need to have our long season corn in the ground. So for that reason, we have time enough to let the soil dry out underneath that mat of corn stalks, and the no-till system with our soybeans works great. Now, I'm not saying no-tilling corn on corn doesn't work. I'm just saying that in our area, with our tight soils and our tight planting window in the spring, it doesn't work very well for us. There are some fields in our area even that are so sandy that they work out just fine for corn on corn no-till, but those are few and far between. Most of the people around us are doing fall tillage just like we are. Let's jump out of the tractor quick and take a closer look at this piece of equipment we're pulling so that you can see exactly how it works. This is a Landall 2111 Coulter chisel being pulled by a Case 340 Magnum. The reason it's called a Coulter chisel is it has this row of coulters right out front designed to chop up and size the residue into small bits so that it can flow easily through the rest of the chisel. Next comes a few rows of twisted chisel shovels designed to lift the soil and roll it over on top of the residue. And last, we have the tine harrow. Its job is to spread out any piles of corn stalks and to level the uneven surface of the ground after it's made its way through the twisted shovels. Thanks for riding along for this tutorial on fall tillage. I hope I was able to answer some of your questions. So to wrap up this video, here's a little summary of our struggles trying to get the tillage done in the fall of 2019. After getting our first 100-acre field finished in pretty good conditions, we received our first of 5 snowstorms in the month of November. So here we are trying to chisel plow in the snow, sliding all over the place. The ground was freezing up too hard every night for us to be able to pull it the next morning. We thought this was how it was going to be, and then the snow melted off and the rain started in, and the ground got even wetter. So here we are again at 2 o'clock in the morning trying to start chisel plowing while the ground is still frozen, hoping that we can pull it. We've finished up our harvest in the dark on frozen ground, and now we're trying to finish up our tillage in the dark on frozen ground. I see the neighbor over there. He's got his semi parked in the driveway. They're trying to combine corn right now. Everybody's trying to get her done. It's getting really late. You gotta do what you can do. We're supposed to get down to 28 degrees. It's currently just after 5 o'clock in the morning and it's still 31 degrees. It didn't really freeze as much last night as it should have or as they claimed that it was going to. We're doing a pretty good job where we can pull it okay, but I'm getting into some places where the manure applicator overlapped as it was turning around a little bit, and it's marginal at best. I'm having trouble pulling it in those spots. I wouldn't want to do it every day, but there's something kind of neat about watching the sun come up from the cab of a tractor or a combine or whatever you happen to be out in.
Now every day when the sun gets high in the sky and melts the ground just enough that we can't pull the chisel plow on our manure fields anymore, we'd pull it out of the ground and go ripping down the road to try to find a new field that did not have manure applied to it and try to turn some of that dirt over in hopes that it would be drier on top. Sometimes it was, sometimes it wasn't. Usually we got slimed out about 2 o'clock in the afternoon regardless of where we were. But today, I finally found a field that worked a little better further into the afternoon. Man, this is great. It's actually working really good over here. I kind of get the feeling that the frost is finally all gone and maybe we'll actually be able to run on this farm the rest of the afternoon without any trouble. I might be wrong, but here's to hoping. Never mind. Not gonna get it done. Not gonna be able to get the end rows done. There's just no way. I'm already carrying it higher than I want to. Not really accomplishing anything. I'm gonna have to get out of here. Because I'm stubborn, I couldn't just give up. So I drove up to the top of the hill at a fairly high rate of speed, and most of the mud flew out from between the lugs on the tractor tires, which definitely helps with traction. And now I'm headed downhill, and I'm still spinning quite a lot, but I may be able to get this. Nope, never mind. It's not gonna work. The end rows are so packed down from the grain cart, which doesn't surprise me at all, that we couldn't even come close to pulling the chisel plow through. And if we can't tear out at least some of that compaction, there's no point in doing it right now. So I'm gonna wait for it to freeze up to finish the end rows on this farm. Kind of a pretty sunrise tonight, or sunset, I guess most of you would call it. Most of you haven't been up since 2 o'clock in the morning either, so cut me a little slack if you would, please. Beautiful.
Hey, I really appreciate you coming along with me today and learning a little bit about chisel plowing. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like or leave me a comment if you have any more questions. And if you enjoyed it enough, I'd appreciate it if you'd go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for riding along. I'll see you next time.